Meu nome é Eduardo Cobra. Eu sou do Brasil, né? Especificamente da cidade.
I'm from Brazil, specifically the city of São Paulo. We were invited to do this painting here in Lexington, me along with two other artists who have been working with me for about 15 years.
Há uns 15 anos. E um deles é o Aguinaldo.
One of which is Aguinaldo, who has been working intensely on the production of the mural, and Cesar as well. So I would like to introduce them because the work is being done jointly by the three of us, because we are a team, really. I started working on the streets around the age of 12 on the outskirts of São Paulo. My first influence was the graffiti of New York, and I started with letters, etc., hip-hop. Over the years, I started developing my own more personal language. And now I have been painting on city streets for over 25 years. I'm also self-taught.
Eu sou autodidata também. Quando eu comecei,
when I started, I was part of a hip-hop group at 13, 14, 15 years of age. And at that point, my influences were entirely within the history of the hip-hop culture. That was way back at the beginning. But as time went by, I went searching for my own identity with other projects and other ideas.
Então, eu tenho projeto.
Well, I have a project, in this case, a mural of Abraham Lincoln, that is really a project of memories. We not only paint iconic scenes, important iconic personalities in history, but also old scenes. Many times we'll take an avenue. For example, we could take this exact area and make it like it looked in 1920, 1930. So we create murals that are portals to the cities of the past. So it's a project of memories. So this scene of Abraham Lincoln has to do with this memory project, which is also similar to what we did in New York City with the VJ Day scene, which is a scene from 1945. The top part of the wall has the scene of the sailor with the nurse, and the bottom part of the wall we have Times Square in 1945. So usually we work with a historic theme.
Trabalha com essa história de temática. Eu procuro obviamente compreender pouco da dinâmica.
I obviously try to understand a little of the dynamics and the history of the place where we are. From here, I look for images and references to something that interests me.
Principalmente me interesse, né?
Obviously, I'm not going to paint something arbitrarily. I take pleasure in what I do. So I look for scenes that are adequate to the space, to the wall. Not just any image will work. So there's a lot of research, and obviously I have my own style, my own way of doing this, a way of reproducing an image. So for this, we research a bank of images and books. Often we visit the place's library, so we do a large amount of research. We just got back from Moscow, and we went through the whole process there. We arrived and didn't even have the image that was going to be painted.
Chegamos lá, a gente nem tinha ainda a imagem que ia ser pintada. Então hoje o que está mais complexo é a logística.
These days, the most complex thing we have to deal with is logistics. Painting in and of itself is the easiest part. Even though the scale is gigantic, it's still the most laid-back part. We have to organize all the materials that will be used, and in the case of a wall of this size, there are the lifts, there are the ladders, there are all the paints. It involves a lot of things. From there, we start with a white background. In this case, we ask that they leave a white background. From there, we sketch the picture, lay out a grid pattern, and sketch. It's like a painting on a canvas, a gigantic canvas. So first we sketch, then we add layers of paint, of light and shadow.
Luz e sombra. E quando eu comecei, eu pintava apenas murais em preto e branco.
When I started, I only did murals in black and white, old scenes, either in sepia or black and white. And São Paulo is a very gray city, very chaotic, there's pollution and such. And people started questioning this, and I started thinking about it too. Why not take these images that are originally in classic black and white and start working them in color? Give them more life. Bring them into the present.
E começar a trabalhar elas com cor, dar mais vida, trazer elas para a atualidade, né? E foi a partir daí que eu comecei a desenvolver uma forma.
It was from there that I began to develop a method of coloring these images. But this was a more than 15-year process, researching, to arrive at an aesthetic that worked.
Numa estética que funcionasse. como o caso disso aqui, que é um...
This is an iconic image that everyone recognizes, but it's a sculpture and a memory in black and white. And obviously, from there, what we are creating is an interpretation.
Nós chegamos a perguntar quais eram...
We asked ourselves, what are the main attractions in the city? And one of the things that came up was horse racing.
Foram as corridas de cavalo, etc., né? Mas a gente não quis fazer algo a respeito disso, né?
But we didn't want to do anything with that. We preferred working with Lincoln because he was born in Kentucky.
Ele é nascido em Kentucky, e aí a gente achou que fosse algo... Nós estamos, eu e minha equipe, muito satisfeitos pela oportunidade.
My team and I are really very happy for the opportunity to work here, especially because of this great wall. It's one of the best walls we've ever painted like this, proportionally, the format, and this is a great place because the city made this space available to us to put our art on.